Good evening, kids. Today's topic is Williamson's synthesis. This method is used for ethers. Now, which type of ethers? Ethers are of two types: symmetrical and unsymmetrical. Symmetricals are the ones where both the R groups are same. R means the alkyl group. Whereas, when we say it is an unsymmetrical ether, it is the two R groups are different. So presently, we are talking about Williamson's synthesis, and this Williamson synthesis is applicable only for unsymmetrical ethers. Now, moving ahead, to prepare an unsymmetrical ether via using the Williamson synthesis, you will be requiring an alkyl halide and a sodium salt of alkoxide, which means if I have to prepare an ether, one is to be a sodium salt of alkoxide and the second is to be a halide. Now, this reaction happens on its own. NaX nikal jayega. You remove the NaX. So, your Na and X are removed. What do you end up with? You're left with RO and an R. So, that's your unsymmetrical ether. It is not as simple as it looks. There are certain conditions which you need to follow. I'll be using those conditions and explaining each of them by a few examples. Example number one. I will be preparing methoxyethane. Now, what is a methoxyethane? Methoxy is OCH3, ethane is 2-carbon unit. So, in a 2-carbon unit, you have an OCH3 attached. Let's satisfy the hydrogens. 3 here, 2 here. So, this is the ether that I intend to prepare. Whereas, you can see, one R group is this, the other R group is this, and they are different. One you have an ethyl, the other you have a methyl. Since they are different, it becomes an unsymmetrical ether. Now, fortunately, both the R groups are 1 degree. Primary, because the carbon to which the oxygen is attached is only attached to one R group or none R group. So, such carbons where you have got 2 hydrogens at least are called as primary carbons. So, this unit is said to be a primary alkyl group. This is also a primary alkyl group. Now, if I want to prepare this particular ether, I have 2 choices. The first choice is I use CH3ONA and I use C2H5Cl to get me the product. Your Na and Cl will be removed. You will be ending up with CH3OC2H5. That's fine. The other method to do the same thing could also be that you could take ONA from the ethyl side and your CH3 could be the halide, it could be a bromide, could be an iodide. And now, if you make them react, your byproduct is going to be NaBr nikal gaya. Br or Na ko nikal do. What are you left with? C2H5OCH3. So, both the methods are correct. The reason being, your both R groups are 1 degree. So, there is no worries. Any method can be used. You can take any of the R groups as halide and any of them as sodium alkoxide. Now, pay attention. I have deliberately written O in a bent geometry, for which you, I hope you very well know, your ether's oxygen of the ether, oxygen has an atomic number of 8. The outermost shell has 6 electrons, out of which you have used 1 here, 1 here. You are still left with 4 more electrons, the 2 lone pair. It is because of these 2 lone pairs that you have a bent geometry. Fine? So, I am always referring it like this, not in a straight line like this. That is not the correct way to write an ether. Coming to the second example, where I am going to prepare anisole. This is a commonly asked question in the examination, to prepare anisole by using Williamson's synthesis. Now, for anisole, you first need to know what is anisole. Anisole is methoxybenzene. So the structure becomes, in which case your R groups are, one is this, the other is this, hence they are different. So it is again an unsymmetrical ether. Now how can I prepare this? Since it is unsymmetrical and both of them are not primary, this is a phenyl alkyl group, this is a 1 degree. So I have two options. I will use both the options and then we will come to a conclusion which is correct. Option 1, I use ONA of the benzene side and Cl from the methyl side. That's one option. And I'm expecting minus NaCl and I'm ending up in a anisole. That is one way of preparing. There's another option. Option 2 is that you use the halide of the benzene and you can use ONA from CH3. In this case also I am expecting NaCl to be removed. Now whenever you have to prepare anisole, this method is incorrect. The reason is you cannot use this. Aryl halide should be avoided. What is the reason? If you remember, the chlorobenzene resonating structures, or for that matter if it is any other halogen also, there are resonating structures where your halobenzene is an electron donating group, which is due to the presence of lone pairs. And if the electrons are given, your first resonating structure itself tells you what the problem arises. As you can clearly see, and you will have a positive charge here also because this electron pair is given off to this bond breaks, you get a negative here and a positive here. My concern is this point. You have a partial double bond character between carbon and X if you are using an aryl halide. Since there is a partial double bond character, this bond would not easily break. Hence, you should avoid the usage of aryl halide. Hence, the correct method is this. So, the first limitation to the Williamson synthesis becomes that your Williamson synthesis, you cannot use, this cannot be benzene. That becomes your first limitation. Your halogen should not be attached to the benzene ring. Moving to the second example on the parallel lines. The second example that I am taking is that of phenytoin. Now what is phenytoin? Phenytoin is ethoxy benzene. Let's draw the structure. This is your benzene. This is your C2H5. This is ethoxy benzene. Let's prepare it from Williamson's synthesis. My option 1. I use benzene chloro plus C2H5ONA as my method. The other option could be you can use ONA on the benzene and your C2H5 could have the halogen. That is the second. In both the cases you are removing Na and Cl. Now which is the wrong option? The wrong option would be the first is the wrong option. The reason, the culprit is this. Halobenzene cannot be used due to the partial double bond character here, due to the resonance where the lone pair of chlorine is given off to benzene, leading to a double bond character here. This won't break easily, so your product formation is not going to happen. So your right route is this. Hence your product is OC2H5, that is phenytoin. So if you're asked to prepare phenytoin by Williamson synthesis or anisole by Williamson synthesis, don't forget your halide cannot be from the benzene ring. Fine. I'll take one last example to clarify the Williamson synthesis topic. The last ether that we are going to prepare is 2-methyl 2-methoxy propane is the ether that we are going to prepare. Whenever you have to write the structure, please write it in the reverse order. Propane means 3 carbons. Methoxy means OCH3 at the second carbon. Methyl means CH3 again at the second carbon. Rest you need to satisfy the hydrogens. So, this is your ether, in which case this is one of the R groups and the second R group is this. So, you again have two different R groups, so it is again an unsymmetrical ether. But in this case, there is a special case where you have this R group is 1 degree while this R group is 3 degree because your carbon is bonded to 3 R groups. While in this case, carbon is not bonded to R groups, so it remains 1 degree. Now, what are the options of this? I would be doing the options in this case. Option 1. I would take the tertiary as the ONA and the primary as the Cl. And I expect that NaCl would be lost and I would end up in the ether required. Now, what is the second option? In option 2, you could have used the halide from the 3 degree and ONA from the 1 degree. Now, this does not give you an ether. Why so? This is 3 degree halide and it is highly reactive. This is ONA, this is basic in nature. Since it is basic in nature, it facilitates the loss of HCl from your 3 degree halide, which means this identity, sodium ethoxide, pulls the HCl from this to lead to formation of CH3, NH goes from here, a Cl from here, leading to this. You do not get an ether, you get an alkene, for the simple reason that if you take a 3 degree halide, this being reactive, it undergoes elimination reaction in comparison to the method that we were expecting. NaCl is not lost, it is HCl which is lost. The basic character of this identity predominates, whereas in this case, this is not that reactive and neither is this much as basic. So, you ended up in an ether, while in this case, your this compound, the 1 degree sodium alkoxide, is a base, while this is highly reactive, it prefers to undergo elimination faster, leading to an alkene. Hence, your second limitation to the Williamson's synthesis becomes that this cannot be benzene was 1 and this should be 1 degree. So, these are the two important limitations of Williamson synthesis. Your Rx may, R cannot be benzene and R should be 1 degree if you have a choice that you have one as 1 degree, other as a 3 degree, as we just did. You had one as 3 degree, one as 1 degree, then your halide should always be under the category of 1 degree. With this, I close the class. Thank you. Please share the video if you like it. Thanks a ton once again. Bye.